Well, yeah, he was gonna have to do that anyway. He's family, so you know, you use people for free. That's, yeah, you know. So we're all starting here. Of course, my mom is here. One of my biggest supporters, my sister, was trying to make it. And I asked the church family to keep praying for us and keep praying for me, that the Lord will move and use and do whatever he has to do until he comes. The single of the CD, it has been released. And the title of the song is called Nothing Without You, and I'm gonna do it this evening. And I'm hoping and praying that you're touched by it, by the song, and just a little history about the song. For me, it was a struggle to learn this song. I'm not writing music. The music was written for me. But I was able to, I'll give you a deeper story at another time, but I don't know if it was just the timing or if it was just the fact that the song was just hard for me to get into. We've gone through a lot this year, my family, with losses and different things of that nature. And so it's been a lot to try to take everything in and continue to push through that and push through that in music that has a message. And so with that being said, I'm gonna do my best on my own song. I want you all to pray for me, and I hope that you're blessed by it. I might though. Strive. I remember.
Wasn't that beautiful? Oh, amazing, amazing. Congratulations, Angel. God bless you. Sister Joan, I don't know your last name. Come render us your selection. You sang beautifully this morning. Appreciate that. Thank you so very much. I told you we have talent. We don't need anybody. We have all our talent right here. Right here. Praise God.
They want what you sang this morning.
Oh no, I don't have it. It's outside.
There once was a woman who came to the well, seeking release for her thirst. Everyone knew of her bad reputation. She was considered the worst. But that day she found more than just water. She met the hope of the world. She left town with one name. Won't they be surprised of what she says when she returns? My new name is sanctified. I'm holy, just call me the righteousness. I'm now known as new creation. My nickname is covered by the blood. When hell calls me bound by my past, God calls me free at last. Nothing's the same since Jesus came.
My friends used to call me by so many names. I hardly remember them all. The two-faced liar, the life of the party, are some of the names I recall. But that day I took a trip to the altar. My whole way of living has changed. I knew what I was. Now I know who I am. And nothing about me is the same. My new name is sanctified. I'm holy. Just call me the righteousness. I'm now known as new creation. My nickname is covered by the blood. When
Yes, yes. Ha! All that past is gone away because you got your new name. Yes, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord for that. Thank you for that reminder. Ha! My mother-in-law, come on. Give us your words. I saw you come in. I told y'all I had somebody. Everybody's doing something. Yes, yes, yes. I love it. I haven't heard my mother-in-law do her recitals in a long time. So I'm so glad I get to hear you again. Oh, and the men's chorale, are you here? If you are, get prepared. If you are, let somebody, let me know if you're going to be here.
I'm reading this because when I heard the pastor's sermon this morning, it triggered this one. So I pulled this one out instead of the one that I had planned to do. So listen very carefully because I'm going to try to read this. 'Twas the night before Jesus came, and all through the house, not a creature was praying. Not one in the house. Their Bibles were laying on the shelf without care in hopes that Jesus would not come there. The children were dressing to crawl into bed, not once ever kneeling or bowing their head. And Mom in her rocker with baby on her lap was watching the late show while I took a nap. When out of the east there arose such a clatter, I sprang to my feet to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but angels proclaiming that Jesus was here. With a light like the sun sending forth a bright ray, I knew in a moment that this must be the day. The light of his face made me cover my head. It was Jesus returning just like he said. And though I possessed worldly wisdom and wealth, I cried when I saw him in spite of myself. In the book of life, which he held in his hand, was written the names of every saved man. He spoke not a word as he searched for my name. When he said, "It's not here," my head hung in shame. The people whose names had been written with love, he gathered to take to his Father above. With those who were ready, he rose without a sound, while all the rest were left standing around. I fell to my knees, but it was too late. I had waited too long and had thus sealed my fate. I stood and I cried as they rose out of sight. Oh, if only I had been ready tonight. In the words of this poem, the meaning is clear. The coming of Jesus is drawing near. There's only one life, and when comes the last call, we'll find that Bible was true after all.
Yes, I remember those poems. Oh man, that was beautiful. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So we cannot miss that call. That's all y'all gonna say? Amen. Ooh, You want your name written there? I sure do. We're gonna have an offering. Ladies, y'all ready? Come on. While we're doing offering, we're gonna sing a song. Somebody got a special song they like to sing? Anything? The Lord is blessing me? You like that, huh? Come on, my praise team, those that are here, come sing with me. The Lord is blessing me. Y'all don't want to help me sing? Oh, wow. Come on, y'all. We're going to sing. The whole church going to sing. All right. They're going to hurt my feelings. Thank y'all. Thank you. Is it on? Lord, for this offering, Lord, we ask you to spread it as far as it can go. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right. At this time, we're going to hear from my bestie, Joy Mason. She's going to sing for us. And after Joy, Audra, are you ready, my dear? Yes. Okay. And after Joy, we'll hear from Audra Mark. Thank you.
Good afternoon.
Choice. Even though you knew the lines you had to cross for me, you made them anyway. Voices, as you knelt there in the garden neath the olive tree, I heard you call my name, and I could not pretend to understand it all, 'cause heaven knew the reason you were there. It was all about a man. It was all about a cross. It was all about the blood that was shed so I would not be lost. It was all about love that was bigger than life. It was all about the cause you would rather die than to ever live without me. Helpless, that's humanity without your saving grace. so misled, selfless. You could have caught 10,000 angels down to take my place, but you took mine instead. And I can't pretend to understand it all, but heaven knew the reason you were there. It was all about a man. It was all about a cross. It was all about the blood that was shed so I would not be lost. It was all about a love that was bigger than life. It was all about the freedom that was given through your sacrifice. 'Cause you would rather die, you'd rather die than to ever live without me. That he would lay his life down for his friends. It was all about a man. It was all about a cross. It was all about the blood that was shed so I would not be lost. It was all about a love that was bigger than a life. It was all about the freedom that was given through your sacrifice. 'Cause you would rather die, you'd rather die than to ever live without me. To ever live without me.
That was so beautiful, God. Jesus loved us so much that he'd rather die. Is that beautiful or not? Don't forget it. Don't forget it. Come on, Audra. After Audra will be, I just got a brain fluff, Edward. And then after Edward will be my sister Gregory.
Good evening, everyone. I wanted this to be kind of interactive, so I wrote it like a cheer. So I'm gonna ask you to please call out the letters for the word harvest, okay? All right, let's start. Having a healthy lifestyle is one of the things for which we're known. Always giving praises to God for the bounty that was grown. Reaping the harvest of souls as we fellowship and share God's word. Victory in Jesus is shown by the testimonies that are heard. The everlasting gospel that's a free gift to all. The sustaining power of love that's in this end time call. Together, this spells harvest and a time to give and share for you and me, and no church celebrates it better than right here at DO.
I like that one. Yes, thank you, Audra. She's always using her teaching skills, isn't she? She'll get everybody involved. Thank you, Audra. I appreciate that. Edward, come on.
No, nowhere. It's okay.
Jesus, you're the center of my joy. All that's good and perfect comes from you. Oh, oh. You're the joy of my contentment, hope for all I do. Oh, Jesus, you're the center of my joy. One more time, Jesus, you're the center of my joy. Oh, my, all that's good and perfect comes from you, from you, from you, from you. You're the joy of my contentment, hope for all I do. Oh, Jesus, you're the center of my joy. You are why I find pleasure in the simple things in life. You're the music in the meadows and the streams. The voices of my children, my family and my home. You're the start and finish of my highest dreams. Oh, my Jesus, you're the center of my joy, my joy. All that's good and perfect comes from you, from you. Yes, it does, yes, it does. Oh, you're the source of my contentment, hope for all I do. Oh, Jesus, you are the center of my joy. Jesus, you are the center of my joy. Jesus, you are the center of my joy. You are everything, 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 yeah, everything. Now, Jesus, you're the center of my joy.
Of your joy, you can't let Satan steal your joy. You gotta let Jesus. Yes, we gotta be the center of your joy. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. I just need you guys to. My dad just told me that Aunt Jerry had to leave to take Uncle Merv King to the emergency room. He wasn't feeling well. So if you guys can pray, and we're gonna just have a moment right now, just to have prayer for him. What do I have, babe? You come pray, give up a special prayer for Uncle Murray for us, please.
Let us pray. Father God, again, we thank you for being God in spite of us. And we know that the devil is busy and he's seeking out who he may devour. Father, we ask that you would be with Brother King. We don't know his situation. And if we did, we couldn't do anything anyway. So Father, we placing it in your hands that you will go before they even reach the hospital, that the doctors will already know what to do and know whatever his diagnosis is. Father, you said that anything that you ask in my name, that I'll do it. And Father, we're just stupid enough to believe in what you say. Father, here's another one of your sheep, another one of your soldiers. that have been on the battlefield for the Lord for a long time. And so, Father, we're asking that you will be with him, be with his wife and the thoughts that's in her mind, and remind her of what you can do, that God can do anything if we just trust. So, Father, we just know that you're going to be ahead of this, and know that Brother King is going to come back and be directing the choir. So, Father, we thank you for what you're going to do and for what's already done. In the name of your son, Jesus, we do pray. Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. We're going to thank him in advance. Am I right? We're going to praise that there's healing. He's going to be healed. Are we right? Yes, because we have faith and trust and believe, because he is the ultimate physician. All right. Sister Gregory.
Good evening, everyone. I have a surprise for you. I am not going to say a word. I was looking around in my brain when I was asked, and I couldn't come up with anything. So I took a book that I have, and I started looking. And I found something that I have never heard for years. And it is my pleasure to share it with you. So please listen and enjoy. The deck of cards. I'll take my seat.
Mes amis, qui sont nos idoles? L'argent? La puissance? La gloire? La science? Elvis Presley? Madonna? Tout cela. Façonne le bois avec un couteau.
During the North African campaign, a bunch of soldier boys had been on a long hike. They arrived in a little town called Casino. The next morning, being Sunday, several of the boys went to church. A sergeant commanded the boys in church, and after the chaplain had read the prayer, the text was taken up next. Those of the boys who had a prayer book took them out, but this one boy had only a deck of cards, and so he spread them out. A sergeant saw the cards and said, "Soldier, put away those cards." After the service was over, the soldier was taken prisoner and brought before the provost marshal. The marshal said, "Sergeant, why have you brought this man here?" "For playing cards in church, sir." "And what have you to say for yourself, son?" "Much, sir," replied the soldier. The marshal said, "I hope so. For if not, I shall punish you more than any man was ever punished." The soldier said, "Sir, I have been on the march for about 6 days. I had neither Bible nor prayer book, but I hope to satisfy you, sir, with the purity of my intentions." And with that, the boy started his story. "You see, sir, when I look at the ace, it reminds me there is but one God. The deuce reminds me that the Bible is divided into two parts, the Old and the New Testaments. When I see the tray, I think of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And when I see the four, I think of the four evangelists who preached the gospel. There was Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And when I see the five, it reminds me of the five wise virgins who trimmed their lamps. There were 10 of them. 5 were wise and were saved. 5 were foolish and were shut out. When I see the 6, it reminds me that in 6 days God made this great heaven and earth. And when I see the 7, it reminds me that on the 7th day God rested from his great work. And when I see the 8, I think of the 8 righteous persons God saved when he destroyed this earth. There was Noah, his wife, their sons, and their wives. And when I see the 9, I think of the lepers our Savior cleansed, and 9 out of the 10 didn't even thank him. When I see the 10, I think of the 10 commandments God handed down to Moses on a table of stone. When I see the king, it reminds me there is but one King of heaven, God Almighty. And when I see the queen, I think of the Blessed Virgin Mary, who is Queen of Heaven, and the Jacker Knave is the devil. When I count the number of spots on a deck of cards, I find 365, the number of days in a year. There are 52 cards, the number of weeks in a year. There are 4 suits, the number of weeks in a month. There are 12 picture cards, the number of months in a year. There are 13 tricks, the number of weeks in a quarter. So you see, sir, my pack of cards serves me as a Bible, an almanac, and a prayer book. And friends, the story is true. I know I was that soldier.
I do hope you enjoyed it, like I do. May God bless us as we continue to serve him.
Amen. Thank you so much, Sister Greggy. That was awesome, wasn't it not? At this time, we're gonna have our closing prayer by Willie Farrington. Come on. That was my vesper, I'm sorry. Oh, that's okay, thank you.
Let us stand. Hope you guys had a wonderful time. Well, the display of talent we have here embedded in the Daughter of Zion Church. We heard from the spoken word, from those who lend their voices to God. We're going to pray that God give us guidance, that we take what we have learned and seen and witnessed here today to those who weren't able to participate in worship. Dear God in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for the opportunity we have to worship your name in prayer. We thank you, Lord, for what we have seen and witnessed, but we know, Lord, that it's not just for us. There are those who don't know of the message of hope and salvation that we have embedded in our heart. So we want to leave these doors invigorated, inspired, and challenged to share the word of truth, a message of hope, and a message of love to a dying world. We want to be a part of that number that no man can number, that will stand on the sea of glass, and we will cast our crowns at your feet, because you are a God that came down and died for our sins. But not only that, you said that you will come again and receive us unto yourselves. Bless us, keep us, and forgive us. In your name we do pray, amen.